One way we can actually fix this problem of the red circles and not being able to know what they represent is by a very simple addition of a legend to our chart. A legend is useful to associate a label to each of the circles here. Let's see what that looks like in D3. A very simple but powerful way to add context to your visualization or graphic is through the simple use of text to add labels or annotations. I wanted to go through and show you how to add a legend using text, but this process can be extended to adding any sorts of labels or annotations to any point on your graphic. What we have here is pretty standard, and we've seen it before with all the circles, is we simply append to an SVG some group element, giving it a class of legend. We simply move that group to be X position 100 less than the width, so it's going to correspond to the width minus 100, and a Y position of 20. So again, Y position of 0 is the top of our chart, so this is going to be 20 pixels down from the top. Again, this is one of those quirks with D3. So we've appended a group and then select that same group we've appended. We bind data to it, in this case, simply the strings home team and others. And this is also to show you the flexibility that your data doesn't have to come from a file. It doesn't have to have many rows in it. In this case, it's simply a JavaScript array with two strings in it. Since we don't already have a legend on our page, the .enter selection is going to return two group elements, one for the home team and one for the others, or rather placeholders. And then for each of those placeholders bound to home team and others, we append a group element. Again, if that seemed confusing in words, look back to what we did with the circles or run each of these functions in a web console to see what values are passed in and out at every step of the chain. So now we have a legend with SVG group elements bound to some data, but we don't have text yet.